Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. Now the problem that you see on your screen right now is taken from the official SAT study guide practice test number 1, the Math section, section 3, where no calculator is allowed, and this problem is problem number 4. Okay, section 3, problem number 4, exam number 1. So this is a word problem where you're given a linear model and you're expected to understand the meaning behind the numbers shown in the equation, right? So let's read about these numbers and we'll see what they mean in context of the problem. So Kathy is a repair technician for a phone company. Each week she receives a batch of phones that need repairs. The number of phones that she has left to fix at the end of each day can be estimated with the equation P is equal to 108 minus 23 times D, where P is the number of phones left and D is the number of days she has worked that week. Right? What is the meaning of the value 108 in this equation? Right, so the first thing that you should understand is that this is a linear model. And how do we know that? We know that because one variable is expressed in terms of the other variable, and the variable in terms of which the P is expressed is D, right? And D is raised to the first power, right? That's why we know it's a linear model, right? So for a specific amount of D, P will show a decrease. And how do we know that P will decrease with the increase of D? Is because there's a negative sign in front of 23, right? So as D increases, it will make this quantity, the negative quantity, smaller, but absolute value bigger, which will make the increase of P even greater. The decrease of P will be even greater than before, right? So now they're asking you, what is the meaning of 108? So what does this number mean, 108? So the simplest way to understand this is that once you understand that this is a linear model, this is a linear equation, then you know that when D is equal to 0, all you will have left is P is equal to 108. So if we let D is equal to 0, and we must understand what D equals 0 means, it means the time when she starts working at the beginning of each week, right? So D is 0, that means she didn't really start fixing the she didn't start fixing phones yet, right? So D is equal to 0. So once we set D is equal to 0, we will have P is equal to 108 minus 23 times 0, right? Because we set D is equal to 0, and then we'll have 108 minus 0, which will simply give us 108. Okay? So 108, and since she didn't work at all, right, this is the initial time during the beginning of each week that she'll work, when she's going to start working. That means that 108 will be the initial number of phones that needs to be repaired at the beginning of each week. And which answer choice is very similar to what we just found? Answer choice B, right? Because it says Kathy starts each week with 108 phones to fix. Right, so at the beginning of each week, she will start with 108 phones. And we know that because we set D is equal to 0. Keep in mind that this equation, given equation, works for each week. It doesn't work for all weeks together or doesn't overlap the first or second week. It just works for each week. Right? Because if you set D is equal to 5, you will be over 108. So you will have a negative result. So whoever has written this problem probably expects that she doesn't work 5 days a week. She works less than that, right? Because otherwise it would overlap 108, it would go in the negative direction, and you would have a negative number, right? So we definitely should know that we're talking about 1 week only, right? So this equation is given per week. So the correct answer choice, again, is answer choice B. Kathy starts each week with 108 phones to fix.